हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट दिस इज़ माय फर्स्ट वीडियो। बिफोर यू स्टार्ट प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल के इफ़ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज़ शेयर विथ योर फ्रेंड्स आल्सो एंड इफ़ यू हैव एनी डाउट कमेंट मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन। ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। होमोजीनियस फंक्शन, ओके, यूलर्स फंक्शन इज मेनली ऑन द होमोजीनियस फंक्शन ओनली। Before going to Euler's theorem, first we shall see the homogeneous function. A function u equals to f of x comma y is said to be homogeneous function of degree n if it can be expressed in the form x raised to n g of y by x, or it may be expressed as y raised to n g of x by y. So see here, it means that any function which can be expressed in the form of x powers, okay, x powers n may be any integer, okay, and g into the function g of y by x, or if we are trying to express in terms of y, then the function function is of the form g of x by y. Okay, so let's see some example. Example 1, f of x y equals to x cube plus y cube divided by x minus y. So see here I will take x cube common in the numerator, then we get 1 plus y cube divided by x cube whole divided by, in the denominator I will take x as a common, then we get 1 minus y by x. So some of in your mind a question arises that how you taken this x cube as a common, because here there is no term of x, so then how can we take the x cube as a common? So see here, because in the first term x cube is already there, we can easily take the common term, but in the second term y cube, only y cube is there. So here I will multiply and divide by x cube. Okay, so here on taking x cube common in the numerator, only y cube remains, that is here, and in the denominator x cube. Therefore I have written, on taking x cube common, here 1 remains plus y cube divided by x cube. In the same way, here on taking x common 1, we get 1 minus y by x. So it is already known thing, but some of now it can be written as, on taking this x to the numerator we get x square, okay, we get 1 plus y cube divided by x cube whole divided by 1 minus y by x. So see here, we have written this function in terms of x raised to n function of y, g of y by x. So all the terms, all the variables in terms of y by x only, here also it is y by x. Therefore it is a homogeneous function. Now we see the next example. F of x comma y is equals to x power 4 minus y power 4 divided by x plus y. So same as you done in the first example, we can take x power 4 as a common, then we get 1 minus y by x, that is y power 4, and divided by x power 4. Here we can take y, we can write y by x power 4. Similarly in the denominator we can take x as a common, then we get 1 plus y by x. Now on further simplifying we get x cube, and this is a function of y by x. Therefore this can be written as x raised to n g of y by x. Here g of nothing but it is a function, we may denote it by g of y by x, phi of y by x, f of y by x, and so on. So therefore this is also a homogeneous function. Next we come for the next we move for the next example. So see here, this function is cos of x cube plus y cube divided by x minus y. So this function, this one, x cube plus y cube divided by x minus y, this step we have already done, but it is function of, it is cos of the this whole term. So therefore this can be simplified as cos of x cube. So here in the numerator we can take x cube common, in the denominator x. Further simplifying, we get x square 1 plus y by x 1 minus y by x. Now it is the function of cos of x square and 1 plus y by x divided by 1 minus y by x. This is, here we cannot represent it by x raised to n g of y by x, because see here, here total variables y by x are there. So this term, it is in the form of y by x. Even this is also y by x, but this is, it contains only x terms, that is x square is there. We cannot represent it by x by y. Therefore this is not a homogeneous function. If it is only this much, if cos is not present, then we can say that this is a homogeneous function, because it is cos of this term, therefore this is not a homogeneous function. We cannot represent in terms of x raised to n into some function. Okay, therefore this is not a homogeneous function. Now we move for the very very important theorem, that is Euler's theorem on homogeneous function. Euler's theorem for homogeneous functions. Statement of this theorem is, if u equals to f of x comma y is a homogeneous function of degree n, then x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equals to n into u. So this is the statement. Here what we have to prove means x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y equals to n into u. Okay, this is the statement. This theorem will be asked for 5 marks or 6 marks. Euler's theorem for homogeneous functions. Statement: if u equals to f of x comma y is a homogeneous function of degree n, then x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equals to n u. So we have to prove this one. Okay, proof: given u equals to f of x comma y is a homogeneous function . So because it is a homogeneous function, by the definition of homogeneous function, this function can be written as, it can be written as u equals to x raised to n g of y by x. Consider this as equation 1. Now we partially differentiate this function with respect to x and with respect to y. First, partially differentiating with respect to x, differentiating equation 1. So then we get dou u by dou x. So see here, because we are differentiating with respect to x, so this one is also a function, because it contains x term, therefore we treat this as another function. Therefore here we have to apply uv rule. Okay, so we keep x raised to n as it is. Differentiating this g of y by x, we get g dash of y by x into, here we have to write y by x differentiation, because we are partially differentiating with respect to x, y becomes constant. Then we have to write 1 by x differentiation, that is 1 by x, x differentiation is minus 1 by x square. Now plus, we keep g of y by x, this v as it is, differentiate u. Then we get x raised to n differentiation n into x raised to n minus 1. So further simplifying, we can write dou u by dou x equals to, here x power 2 is there, taking to the numerator x powers can be added, then it becomes x power n minus 2. On taking this x square to the numerator, it becomes x power minus 2. Therefore x power n minus 2 into y, minus y is there, therefore I will write minus x power n minus 2 into y. Keep this g dash of y by x as it is, plus here n into x raised to n minus 1 g of y by x as it is. So in the proof we need x into dou u by dou x, therefore I will multiply this term, this equation by x. On multiplying by x, we get x into dou u by dou x, then the right side becomes, so see here, on multiplying this term with x, then x power 1, so we get x power 1, and here we have x power n minus 2, so see here, x power 1 into x power n minus 2, the x powers can be added, then we get x power n minus 2 minus 1 we get, sorry, minus 2 plus 1 we get minus 1. So we keep this minus sign as it is, x power n minus 2 into y as it is, g dash of y by x plus n. Similarly, multiplying x term with this term, we get x, adding x powers plus 1 and minus 1 get cancels, we get x raised to n, and g of y by x also as it is, consider this as equation 2. Again we differentiate equation 1 with respect to y. So equation 1 is u equals to x raised to n g of y by x. So I will partially differentiate. So this is equation 1. Partially with respect to y. So because it contains only one term of y, therefore here there is no need to apply the uv rule. So we directly differentiate dou u by dou y equals to x raised to n becomes constant. Now differentiating this one, we get g dash of y by x into, here we have to write y by x differentiation, 1 by x become constant and y differentiation is 1. Or further simplifying, we get x raised to n, x power 1 is there, on taking numerator it becomes x power n minus 1 into g dash of y by x. Same in the proof, we need y into dou u by dou y. Therefore, we multiply both sides of this equation by y. We get y into dou u by dou y. So multiplying with y, we get y into x raised to n minus 1 g dash of y by x. Consider this as equation 3. Now adding equation 2 and 3, we get LHS becomes x into dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y. So equation 1 plus 2, sorry, 2 plus 3 implies equals 2. Now right side of the equation 2 is x raised to n minus 2, sorry, minus sign is the y g dash of y by x, plus n into x raised to n minus 1 g of y by x. So this is equation 2. Plus equation 3 is y x raised to n minus 1 g dash of y by x. So this is x power n minus 1. On adding these two, so see here, this term minus x power n minus 1, this term and this term will get cancels, only n into x raised to n minus 1 g of y by x remains. therefore x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equals to n x n minus 1 g of y by x, but this term x raised to n minus 1 g of y by x from equation 1, it is equals to u. Okay, from equation 1, therefore x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equals to n into u, and this is the proof of the theorem. Hence the proof. Hope all of you understand this theorem. Okay, now you can note down this theorem. Thanks for watching. In the next class, we shall see how to verify the Euler's theorem. Okay, thank you.